Welcome to Cosmo Nexus, the place where we explore the wonders of our universe. I'm your host, Adam Collins, and today we'll journey to the edge of the universe. Despite everything we've learned, many questions remain unanswered, and today we'll focus on one of the most fascinating aspects, the edge of the universe in time. Let's dive into the cosmic frontier. To understand our journey, we need to understand what the universe is. The universe is everything we can touch, feel, sense, measure, or detect. It includes living things, planets, stars, galaxies, dust clouds, light, and even time. Before the birth of the universe, time, space, and matter did not exist. Despite everything we've learned about our universe, many existential questions remain unanswered. Is our universe finite or infinite? Is it the only universe or just one of many? And most tantalizing of all, what happened at the very beginning, in the first tiny fraction of a second of the hot Big Bang? The answers to these mysteries remain elusive. But there's one thing we can say for certain: the universe does have an edge, not in space, but in time. Because the hot Big Bang occurred 13.8 billion years ago, there's a limit to how far away we can see. Remember, the speed of light, the ultimate cosmic speed limit, imposes a fundamental limit to how far back in time we can look. The farther away we look, the farther back in time we're seeing. As we look to greater distances, we begin to see how the universe grew up to become the cosmic landscape we see today. It's as if we have a time machine, and as we crank the dial backward, we can watch the universe evolve before our very eyes. It's like watching a cosmic play unfold in reverse. But as we go farther and farther away, to earlier and earlier times, this gradually changing picture begins to transform abruptly. When we look back to a distance that's presently 19 billion light years away, corresponding to when only 3 billion years had passed since the hot Big Bang, we see that the universe's star formation reached its maximum. Going back even farther, we start to see significant changes. When we close in on 27 billion light years away, the universe was only 1 billion years old. Star formation was much smaller, and the percentage of the normal matter that's made of heavy elements plummets precipitously. Rocky planets, in these early environments, may well have been impossible. Delving deeper into the past tests the capacity of our present-day telescopes, yet telescopes such as Keck, Spitzer, and Hubble initiated this journey into the unknown in the 1990s. As we venture to places roughly 29 billion light years away or more, we begin to encounter the first boundary of the universe, the edge of transparency. We take for granted, today, that space is transparent to visible light, but that's only true because it isn't full of light-blocking material, like dust or neutral gas. But at early times, before enough stars had formed, the universe was full of neutral gas, and hadn't become fully ionized by the ultraviolet radiation from these stars. And before that, at distances of 45 billion light years away, we come to the earliest stages of all, the ultra-energetic state of the hot Big Bang, where the first atomic nuclei, protons and neutrons, and even the first stable forms of matter were created. Thanks to the expansion of space, this so-called co-moving distance is approximately 45 billion light years, and anything beyond this limit is unobservable to us. It's not that these regions don't exist, but not enough time has elapsed since the birth of the universe for light from these remote areas to reach our telescopes. Like the familiar horizon seen by sailors on the ocean, this cosmological horizon is not some real, physical boundary. Space continues to stretch beyond our observable universe, and there's no reason why there can't be galaxies at these extremely large distances. They're just invisible to us, no matter how powerful our telescopes are. Knowing that the universe extends beyond 45 billion light years doesn't answer whether it's finite or infinite. However, one thing's for sure, the universe does not have a physical edge. There's no cosmic wall, border, or fence at the edges of the cosmos. This doesn't necessarily mean that the universe is infinitely large. According to Albert Einstein's theory of general relativity, we could live in a finite universe, provided that three-dimensional empty space is geometrically curved in a particular way. If the universe has positive curvature, it would be like the curved surface of a beach ball, but instead of a 2D surface, we're talking about 3D space. It's finite, yet there is no boundary or edge to the space itself. On the other hand, a negatively curved universe would be a higher dimensional version of a Pringle, curving upwards along one axis and downwards along the other, while a flat universe would resemble a piece of paper. Both of these versions would stretch out infinitely. Cosmologists have tried to measure the large-scale curvature of space over the past few decades, and the most recent results combined with theoretical arguments seem to indicate that we live in a geometrically flat universe. Convenient because it's easier for our brains to visualize large-scale space curvature using these 2D terms. Bewildering because it implies our universe is infinitely large, and that our observable universe, the part within our cosmological horizon, is only an infinitesimally small fraction of an unimaginably large whole. You might now wonder how our infinite, boundless universe is able to expand. To understand this, let's return to our 2D analogy. Imagine seeing the grid size on a piece of graph paper growing. You would rightfully conclude that the paper is expanding. Now, if the paper was so large that you couldn't see its edge, you'd still draw the same conclusion, even though the piece of paper could also be infinitely large. The same principle applies to our infinite universe. The fact that the universe is expanding doesn't mean that it can't be infinitely large. After all, in the realm of mathematics, infinity times 2 is still infinity. So, while it's certainly mind-boggling to consider, current evidence and theories suggest that our universe is both infinite and constantly expanding. This paints an awe-inspiring picture of our place in the cosmos, a tiny, observable fraction within an unimaginably vast, boundless, and ever-expanding universe. Now, you might be wondering, if we can't see beyond the observable universe, how can we know anything about it? That's a great question. When we look at distant objects in the universe, we are also looking back in time. The light from a distant galaxy that is a billion light years away, for instance, shows us the galaxy as it was a billion years ago. So, by observing distant objects, astronomers can study the history of the universe. So, what's beyond the edge of the universe? Well, we simply don't know. It's like asking what's north of the North Pole. It's a question that might not even make sense. Our current understanding of physics breaks down when we try to describe the very beginning of the universe. At the moment of the Big Bang, all the laws of physics as we know them cease to be useful. In that infinitesimal first moment, the universe was condensed into a point of infinite density and temperature, called a singularity. Was there a before the Big Bang? We don't know. Some theories suggest that our universe might be one in a series of universes, a sort of cosmic cycle of birth, death, and rebirth. Others postulate that our universe could be one of an infinite number of universes in a vast multiverse, each with potentially different laws of physics. And there are even more wild theories out there. But the truth is, we just don't have enough information to say for sure. We've reached the very edge of our understanding, the edge of the universe as we know it. And yet, every unanswered question is a call to explore, to learn, to push the boundaries of our knowledge. Our journey to the edge of the universe is far from over. As we continue to observe, to experiment, to theorize, who knows what incredible new understandings await us. In the words of the great Carl Sagan, somewhere, something incredible is waiting to be known. And there you have it, folks, another journey through the stars has come to an end. We hope you enjoyed this episode and, as always, learned something new about our incredible universe. If you're as fascinated by space and the cosmos as we are, then make sure to hit that subscribe button and the notification bell so you won't miss any of our future explorations. Your support helps us continue this journey and bring more exciting content to you. Also, if you found today's topic interesting, don't forget to share this video with your friends and family. They might enjoy this cosmic journey as much as you did. We'd love to hear your thoughts, so feel free to drop a comment below. Thank you for joining us on this cosmic journey. I'm Adam Collins, and this is Cosmo Nexus, bringing the universe to your doorstep. Stay curious, keep exploring, and as always, keep looking up.